welcome to my kitchen. And tonight we're going to do an episode of Prepper's Pantry, because everything I'm going to make tonight comes from the food storage. Well, everything. The thing I make tonight, all the ingredients are coming from food storage. That's only two ingredients, so I don't know who I'm trying to impress. But I'm also going to be doing a review of a product that I have not used before. And I thought it might be interesting to go ahead and wait until I got everybody on camera and crack it open and then prepare it the way it's instructed on the can and see how we like it. Because sometimes we don't know how stuff is and we go ahead and we buy it and then maybe we don't try it because we're reluctant. But I thought I'm going to give this a try. I'm going to try making this is the chicken noodle soup from Augason Farms. And this comes in what they call the everyday size can. And it says what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to whisk this in to 8.5 cups of boiling water. So I have my water boiling over on the stove. Oh, wow. Okay. That's what it looks like. Noodles and there's no chicken in here, but there's chicken bouillon and they say chicken fat in the ingredients, and there's dehydrated vegetables and egg noodles. So in order to bump up the protein content here, I went ahead and because you've previously heard me talk about, I have to rotate out my food storage for real. And this is some of the canned chicken that I bought before I started canning my own. So, you know, no time like the present. Let's use it up, and then I'll replace it with my own home canned stuff. So let's come over here. And it was boiling. I turned it down. So just dump this in there. Oh, yeah. Don't put the desiccant, the oxygen absorber in your soup. Not good. The one thing I will observe is that these cans have been coated on the inside. That probably won't have me wanting to buy these anymore. Now, I make that observation, but if you'll just bear with me a moment, because now I have to look. I also buy this Spiffy Whip from Augason Farms. Now, I keep a can down here at the ready, because, you know, you never know when you're going to need a whip topping. Oh, see?
And it is. You've never noticed.
That also has a coating on the inside of the can. Now, one thing that does make me not be so concerned about this is that this is a dry product and it's not liquid and it's not acids. Therefore, mm-hmm. I don't believe that, and these are usually kept at a cool temperature, so perhaps my concern is a little premature. So maybe I just won't worry about that, because sometimes we have to do what we have to do. All right, so I've got that in here. This is also supposed to simmer for 12 to 15 minutes. I previously took a fork and broke that chicken up. So I'm going to stir that in there. I've got this down on a medium heat, and I am going to let this simmer. I'm not going to add any seasoning to this, because I want to taste it the way that they have prepared it. And then after I taste it, I'll decide if I want to add anything to it. I know that there's onions and garlic and carrots and spinach and parsley in here. And what else is in here? There is dehydrated onion, dehydrated celery, parsley, spinach, garlic, carrots. There is celery seed, garlic powder, parsley flakes, dried carrots. This is in the seasoning section. And you know, all the other various and sundry things that you may find in there's some turmeric, chicken fat, sugar, onion powder. Nothing that causes me any concern, but this is a food storage product and I've been wanting to try it. I purchased this before Christmas. Now, if you go to the Augason Farms website, which I frequent every day because they have a daily deal and they have a deal that rotates every 2 weeks. And these canisters of soup, I bought this and I bought a potato. Now, my friend Cat's Cradle has tried the potato soup and really enjoys it. She says that she enjoys adding more water to it than the can actually calls for, because she felt that it was a little thick for her taste. So that's the beautiful part about these, is that you can make them to suit your own family's taste. But I was saying, I believe I paid $5.95 or so for this size can, and I bought three each of the chicken noodle and the potato. And yeah, perhaps that's a lot for something I have never tried before, but $6 is no big deal. And really, in an SHTF situation, if someone came to your door and you wanted to help them that one time that you say, here, I'm going to help you and please don't come back, you hand them this and you hand them a gallon of water and you tell them to be on their way. What they do with it after that is entirely their decision. But this is also a nice thing to have on hand. It's a nice size, because if what happens if we get in that situation, I don't know many of the people that I know who are preppers who are heartless enough to turn someone away.
Another good giveaway is ramen noodles.
Yeah, and we have said that we have a bin full of ramen noodles that is for just that very thing. Because I'll help you once, but I can't help everybody, and I think that that God doesn't want us to not help people, because that's why we're here, is to help each other. So anyway, on that note, I'm gonna let this soup simmer for about 10 more minutes, and then we'll be back and we're gonna give it the taste test. So we'll be back. Okay, we're back, and this has been simmering about 15 minutes.
It smells really good.
It smells fantastic. So let's see. The noodles are good. It's got lots of noodles in it. It looks really pretty. Let's see here. You get a spoon. That's a fork, not a spoon. Can't eat soup with a fork, can I? I can see all the vegetables in it, and it looks like they have rehydrated. And of course, I put that chicken in there, so we've bumped up the protein factor. So let me just taste the broth. Let me switch places with Rick. Let's see, you can show me. Let's see. Let's see what this is going to be like. It's got really good flavor. Molly, come here. It's not at all too salty. Sometimes these mixes can be too salty. Taste this. Here.
Tell me what it tastes.
Well, no. Molly's tasting. Show Molly. It's good. It's good, huh? Mm-hmm. All right, well, I would say that this is prepared exactly the way they said on the can. All I did was add some chicken to it. So, my own personal preference, I would probably add a little salt to it, but I like my food a little salty, and I'm going to add some cracked black pepper to my serving. So, in all, I would say the Augason Farms chicken noodle soup in the everyday can is very good, and I think I will buy it again. And I think that if you are at all interested in trying any long-term food storage, I highly recommend you head on over to Augason Farm, who does not ask me for an endorsement of any kind. I am doing this of my own free will and volition, and I was not asked to do this at all. I wanted to do this because I think it's very important that we all know the things that we're buying are good to eat. Because if we get in a situation where we have to use this stuff, then when it's too late, that's too late to find out that it's crap. And we spend a lot of money on these things, so we may as well know what we're buying. And if I can help you understand that this is delicious, in my opinion, then I think that you can be confident if you want to go over there and buy a case of six cans, then you know you're not throwing your money away. And also, this is a fabulous help them in a hurry idea, because when you get home and you don't really know what you want to cook, a big bowl of soup and a hearty slice of bread is an excellent idea, because that's what we're having tonight. So, I hope this helps, and I hope you try it, and I hope you love it, and until next time, I'll see you.